Ladies and gentlemen, it is March 13th, 2014. Whoa, almost said 13. I'm still in 2013. This 2014 is just not right for
Your
me.
Your head game is still there, but still it there. Is looking like March. It's looking like spring.
Yes, it
I
is.
Cannot believe it. I am ready for the snow to come back already.
I can't believe that we went from this much snow within 2 days. We're about to this much snow.
In Cleolum, there's no snow. I just had the bonfire for the first time in my front yard just the other night.
No burn bans, so
no
take
burn
advantage.
Bans. I am.
I'm Nolan Weiss.
And I'm Jeffrey Jorgensen.
And this is a couple local boys bringing you some local news each week, starting at 7 p.m. on Thursdays are our new ones, or you can check us if it's too late, 7 p.m. the next day, Friday at 7 a.m., where we have all of this great news brought to you each week.
Spring reminds me of Mother's Day and Father's Day, and if you ask me, this next story that we're going to talk about, this father deserves Father of the Year.
He does.
Absolutely.
Very amazing man right here. From China, this man carries his disabled son 18 miles to school and back, and thank you to the Chinese government. They are going to help him with some action to take to help him get his son to school without having him carry the child on his back.
Very impressive. Wow. That father is the Father of the Year. In my book, 18 miles, that's not just 18 miles round trip, that's 18 miles there, 18 miles back.
And for his kid's education, which shows this man has no selfishness in his bone right there. It's amazing that he brings that his own son on his back to school each day.
Very impressive, and he gets a great workout.
Yeah, so congratulations, man in China. You are our Father of the Year.
And our Skier of the Year, our very own local Patrick Deneen, coming in sixth place in the Olympics, sixth in the world. Is impressive. If you ask me, he got shorted a bit by the judges.
He did.
Just, I mean, it's kind of sad and disappointing, but at the same time, he is our number one Olympian.
He's our Upper Kittitas County hero for sure.
Yes, he is.
Kittitas County hero because Patrick Deneen, keep up the great work. He is number one ranked in nationals and number three ranked in the world for downhill moguls. And hopefully he sticks with it and gets a medal in the next U.S. Winter Olympics.
We know cool. We're going to see him there next time too.
Well, sure. And we know we're going to see him right now because I got an interview with him when he was in town, and here he is. Nolan Weiss here with NTV, and not every day you get to stand in Cleolum with a Olympian, and I'm with here Patrick Deneen, the Rocket, and how was the Olympics for 2014, Pat?
Sochi was a really incredible place. I was really lucky and honored to represent my country on such a large stage, and I didn't end up on the podium, but I still had a really great day.
You did have the fastest time too on the end time, which I thought that's what downhill moguls was all about. How do you get judged on the downhill moguls?
So mogul ski is broken into three different judging categories. One is air, which is 25% speeds, 25% turns, or 50%. Normally, speed and turns have a little more correlation than they did at the Olympics, but they decided to run a new format at the Olympics the way we qualified through all the rounds, and then also it looks like they judged a little bit differently than I would have thought they would have.
From this Olympics to from your previous Olympics, which one was more special? If I know it's a hard question because hands down, both of them have to be so special, but which one just kind of stands up maybe higher than the other?
Vancouver was Vancouver's a really beautiful place, and it's really cool having the Olympics so close to where I live.
Oh yeah.
But on the other side of things, Russia, they did such an incredible job with their Olympics. Especially with how doomsday everything was sounding before we went there, I was starting to get pretty nervous, and then once we got there, like, everything was so safe. The people were really friendly, and it's one of the prettiest spots in the world.
Is the snow different from here to from Russia? or is it just all snow?
Ultimately, it's just all snow. When we first arrived there and during all the training days, we were skiing and it was bulletproof ice. It was about as hard as it could get.
Some pretty painful stuff if you fall.
Yeah, you didn't want to fall. And then for the competition, everything just totally blew apart, and it was a completely different course. So things changed quite a bit, and some guys capitalized on it, and other guys didn't.
Did you get a walk in the opening ceremony?
Yeah, that was a really, really fun thing to do, walking in the opening ceremony. And then also, compared to Vancouver, that was a lot cooler, because I think we walked in earlier, so we watched a lot of the opening ceremonies, and it was incredible.
It looked amazing on TV. Was it just amazing in person, seeing those humongous floating objects?
Yeah, I'm excited to look good on television, because I wasn't sure how well it's going to look on television, because sitting there, it was incredible.
It was nuts on TV.
The enormous... the size of everything, like when they brought the train out in opening ceremonies, was insane.
That girl floating is like, yeah. She's 13 or 14 years old floating.
Yeah, and she's so high up, yeah. I couldn't believe it, yeah.
So that's special. So you got to wear, you have one of those sweaters too, the American sweaters?
Yeah, I have the American sweaters. I didn't check my number. I guess they're all hand numbered. And so there's like 324 or something. Ralph
that's
Lauren
a special
made.
Thing to have.
Yeah, so I haven't checked my number, but I have one of 324.
Cannot wait. I hope the best of luck to you in the upcoming events, and hopefully to see you in 2018 Winter Olympics, and to see you on that podium.
Awesome.
It'd be a special thing.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, man.
Thank you.
March 7th was a busy day. After the parade down in Clay Elm, we went up to the school where CeCe Batta and BJ Batta were having an auction and dinner because of the fire that happened in their house a couple weeks ago. So they were having a great turnout with a lot of money raised for the two to get some belongings back and some peace of mind from that fire. And Eddie was there to get some footage for you guys.
It is a benefit dinner for BJ and CeCe. They lost their house in a fire on February 9th. They lost everything in their home, and so we're trying to support them and help them out a little bit. About 2 weeks ago, my dad approached me. He works here at the school. My dad approached me to see if we could do something like this, and I had to clear it through BJ and CeCe because it's just a respectful thing to do. And we contacted Easton School because that's where CeCe works, and we were able to get everything set up and start the benefit and get it rolling. We've had a lot of businesses around town donate as well, so it's been good. Owens Meats donated 120 pounds of beef and sausage. The Clay Elm Bakery donated 25 loaves of garlic bread. The Old Number 3 in Ronald made all the sauce, and Easton School donated all the spaghetti noodles and the salad. And we're only in the first hour, and we've hit probably over 400 people so far. There's been an account set up at Washington Federal for BJ and CeCe. So if you go to the Washington Federal Bank in Clay Elm, there's an account set up for them in their name under BJ and CeCe Batta.
Last I heard, $7,000 was raised at that event.
Wow.
I believe they counted around 5,000 at the event, and then after a couple days, it was 7,000, and I'm sure even more money is going to start coming in. That just proves how tight-knit our community is, and when destruction like this takes place and how devastating it is, it makes us realize how blessed we are to live in a place that we do.
And talking about being blessed on where we live, I was at a fundraiser the other night for Baby Henley, a baby that is going through a really rare disease, and they raised a lot of money at the Brick where they volunteered their time, and all the tips went to Baby Henley and their family. She's undergone a lot of surgeries, and she hasn't even hit the age of one yet. So please, if you want to help Baby Henley, go to the Brick and donate some money for their cause.
Staying on the Brick topic, the Brick Spittoon Boat Races took place this past weekend. This is an annual event. It wasn't as good of a turnout as it was in the years past, but I think that was based on advertising. There wasn't much. I didn't even really hear about the Spittoon races until the day that it was taking place.
Probably a smart thing right there. Get it on NTV and would let everybody know about those famous Spittoon races. I went there and it was an awesome time though, like every year. It was a little rainy outside, so maybe that was the reason people didn't want to travel, but that did not hold back all the participants of this boat race. Check out all the boats and the great time that you might have missed this last weekend. We'll be right back.
sir. Are you having fun at the boat races?
Always.
You got a boat?
Yeah.
How's it doing? Single elimination?
Yeah.
Oh. So that one shot of glory, it didn't happen.
It didn't happen.
What's your boat's name?
Lego Maego.
And how'd you do with it?
I got second place.
Which means what?
Which means I won $30.
And how'd you get there?
How'd
you get to second place?
My boat floated down water and beat all the boats other than one.
You only lost one race?
No, I lost two races.
So how many did you win?
Three.
So how'd you get there? You won three and lost two?
You're a little late. You know how long ago that was? I got second place. That's all that matters.
Our very own Jared Weiss from Inland Networks taking second in the wax division. Very cool things going on at the Brick.
Yeah, he showed us his little wax boat, but it wasn't much of what he had because he had to wax his wooden boat with that. All of his boat wasn't there. But congratulations, Jared, on getting second place and getting your money back.
We are here with Ron Dolly, president of Sons of Italy Lodge, and he's here to talk to us about the spaghetti feed that's going to be coming up this next Saturday. Ron, how are you?
Very good. Thanks, guys, for inviting me.
Thanks
Pleasure to
have you.
Thanks for coming.
So we have a big event coming up March 2nd. Would you let us know a little bit more about it?
Yep. It's our annual spaghetti feed, and it's a charity event that we use for a scholarship for a high school senior in Cleveland. And the Sons of Italy Lodge was started in 1945 in Cleveland, and our lodge number is 1968. And we roughly have about 20 members now, but boy, we're always welcome for some more. We meet once a month, Saturday, at the bottom of St. John's Church.
Do you have to be an Italian to be able to join the club?
No, you do not. You do not have to be of Italian descent. The only thing is that you can't be an officer in the club.
Well, that's not bad, though. You can still help out, though.
Yes, you can still help out with any functions. And
is there age limitation on who can join?
Nope, as long as you're breathing.
Okay. Good deal. Nice. Good to
so,
know.
So, hey, there's to our viewers a great invite. If you want to help out with the Sons of Italy and get out there and support the great things that they do, like bringing a scholarship to one of our lucky high school students, get out there and help the Sons of Italy.
Looks good on a resume and college transcripts as well.
Yeah. So, Ron, let us know about the spaghetti feed that's coming up March 22nd.
It'll be from 4 to 7. And there's going to be a little different this year. We only printed 200 tickets. Last year we printed over 300, but in the last couple of years we've noticed a drop off in attendance. So if you're planning on coming, the Roslyn Eagles, the Cleolum Eagles, Cleolum Drug, and Galando Sausage all have tickets that are available for sale. And then we'll be selling the remainder of the tickets at the door.
And only 200 spots available, so
that's
make
it.
Sure to get those tickets.
Right. And we'll have our usual, we'll have raffle items, baskets, gift baskets. Tammy and Commissioner Burnt will be selling raffle tickets. We'll have a loud auction with Dave Sandona as the auctioneer. He'll be raffling off some Italian cheeses.
And he can be loud.
He is a riot.
He's fun.
He's awesome.
And then music, as always, is by Oga, Louis O, and Floyd.
There's the reason to go right there in itself. Those three
right.
are amazing.
And then the newest thing we have this year is Corey Weiniger from Ellensburg will be making the Spumoni ice cream.
Mm. And what's Spumoni ice cream, just to make sure?
It's an Italian ice cream that's usually two or three different flavors. It has fruits and nuts chopped up in it.
Mm. Cannot wait for, once again, Sons of Italy Spaghetti Feed.
It is going to be delicious.
And with all the money collected, what does this great event go to?
We have a scholarship committee, which anybody can that's a member of the lodge can be on the scholarship committee. And they review applications from high school seniors, and then they pick one. And then the scholarship is awarded either to them or the college that they choose.
Hmm. And a local student of the Upper Kittitas County, correct?
Right.
Nice.
Either from Clay Ellum or Easton.
Does the scholarship fund depend on how much money is raised at this event? Is that what it is? Or is there a flat rate, like a $500 scholarship to one student or multiple students?
It's $1,000.
It's $1,000, and it goes to one student?
Right. And and depending on how well the spaghetti feed does, possibly two.
Okay.
Wow.
Nice. Very nice. So be sure to go out there, attend, and most importantly, save some money this upcoming week for those auction items, because you cannot beat cheap cheese.
Oh, I love the cheese. And just one more thing, too. You were saying something about some great cheese that you guys are getting that is kind of a rarer cheese to have around this area.
Right. I ordered this cheese from an import store. And this cheese comes from Sardinia, a little island off the coast of Italy. And it's a sheep's milk cheese. It's called Pecorino Romano. And it's kind of a tart cheese for grating over top of
pastas. Yeah.
Yeah. Anything dark and heavy.
Spaghetti.
Yeah,
spaghetti.
There you go.
Yeah, I can't wait for spaghetti and that ice
cream. These are full 5-pound wheels.
Oh, nice. How many did you get?
Wow.
Two.
You got two?
They're very nice. Spendy.
Oh, I bet.
You know, long boat ride from Sardinia to Cleom.
So there's another reason why to go to the March 22nd spaghetti feed at the Cleom Eagles. You can taste some exotic cheese, help a local student in their quest on college and more education, and most importantly, help the Sons of Italy spaghetti dinner and raise as much money as they can for their club.
Once again, we're sitting next to Ron Dolly, president of Sons of Italy Lodge. Thank you, Ron, for spending some time out of your day to come join us here at NTV and talk to our viewers about this.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely.
Pleasure, Ron.
Thank you, boys.
Thanks, bud.
And one more, don't forget, March 22nd, Cleom Eagles, get your tickets because they only have 200 tickets to sell, and this is going to be a great time, once again, put on by the Sons of Italy Foundation.
Student art walks taking place. This is the first art walk of the year. That proves that spring has sprung.
For sure.
And this is going to be held in downtown Roslyn this upcoming Saturday.
The first student art walk, so get out there. You know this is going to be a great one. 16 participating businesses. Every one of them is going to have some great art. They're going to have some jazz and the marimbas, their own art, at the Brick. So make sure to get out there and enjoy the student art walk and love all the art that they have to offer.
First week of the student art walk, that only means one thing: the chili cook-off. Some of the best chili I have ever ate in my entire life. Nothing gets me more excited than this chili cook-off.
This is an event that I love every single year. First time we went to the chili cook-off, I wasn't a fan of chili, but after this event,
a fan of chili?
Because I never just liked all the beans. I never liked the beans. But this opened my eyes to a whole new realm of chili. So get down to the Swaktanoway Grange on March 22nd. That's 1361 Ballard Hill Road in the Swaktanoway Grange. And this is going to be an awesome time. Kids eat free. And for everybody like Jeff and I, just a little fee for some great cowboy music and chili cook-off.
They have chili there that doesn't even taste like chili.
No, it tastes like magical
unicorns in your mouth
blowing with rainbows.
Yeah. Okay.
Just imagine.
Moving right along, the business after hours event is going to be taking place at the Daily Record in downtown Ellensburg.
And is this after work?
Of course, that's why it's called after hours.
Oh, after hours. And this is going on March 20th from 5 to 7. And if you are a business owner or if you are a citizen of Ellensburg or the Upper Kittitas County, get there and enjoy the business after hours that the Chamber of Commerce is going to be putting on. And you'll be enlightened with all the business owners there too.
third annual flashlight Easter egg hunt.
Can't wait. This is
a blast. My favorite part about it is pushing everyone over who is smaller than me.
I get pushed over. I don't push anybody over, but all those little kids.
I fell last year.
Yeah, you fell right on the beginning. Yeah, but that was probably due to your big toe.
Yeah, and then when I fell, I would just like spread my arms out and just wrangled
tripping
up
kids.
Wrangled up a bunch of Easter eggs.
But we didn't win anything.
No, we
didn't. Snicker bars and maybe ice cream cone or something.
I won something. I forgot what it was. I think it was
You won a massage.
I did win a massage and I gave it to my parents.
And you gave it to your parents?
Yes, I did. I did.
Flashlight Easter egg hunt put on by the Vision of Clay Elm. It's going on April 19th. Make sure you get your tickets. It's happening at the Clay Elm Elementary Middle School baseball field. Entry starts at 8 p.m. and the event starts at 9 p.m. It's only $15 per person. Tickets available at the Tribune, Gunner's Coffee Cabin, or at the Vision Clay Elm office, and also at the Senior Center. Prizes include 1 week vacation to Anaheim, California, a 50-inch high-res TV, and a Windows tablet with so many more prizes.
Plus much, much more. And now let's go on to movie reviews with Randy Winkler.
Randy.
Hey, it's Randy Winkler again, your friendly neighborhood movie reviewer. This week, I've got two great movies for you. The first one is 300. It's 300 Rise of an Empire. For those of you that saw the first 300, this is at the same time, only not at the pass, where they were only had 300 guys to keep millions from going through the pass. But this has happened in the sea and in other areas while that fight was going on with some different people. The best thing I can say about it is if you love the first one and you like lots of blood and gore and stuff, you will love this one, as I did. It was just really good. Lots of blood, lots of gore, some story, lots of action. Everything you want out of 2 hours of entertainment. So be absolutely go see it. I would give it a 5 just on blood alone. So be sure and see it. My second movie is Mr. Peabody and Sherman.
DreamWorks, Mr. Peabody and Sherman.
Mr. Peabody and Sherman is a takeoff of a cartoon that was a part of the Rocky and Bullwinkle show years ago. Most of you probably don't even know what I'm talking about, but it was one of the little aside cartoon things that they had on that show, and it was about a dog named Mr. Peabody and his son that he adopted, Sherman, and he would take him back in the Wayback Machine into different times and teach him things about history. And so it was kind of a learning thing and stuff like that. And it was fun at the time. It was just a cute little thing. Well, the movie was awesome. They really did great stuff with it. And I looked around while I was watching the movie and there was adults and kids all around me just with their mouths open, just, you know, and really excited. So I got to say, it's the first cartoon in a while that's crossed all the lines and everybody seems to love it. You should definitely go see it. And a spoiler alert, the only thing they don't do is in the original cartoon, they used to say at the end, he would say, drizzle, drazzle, drizzle, drome, time for this one to come home. And then they would go back to their original time. Well, in this one, they have a time machine, so they don't do that. Anyway, it's really good, clean fun. So have a good time. See movies at your Roslyn Theater and watching TV on Channel 3.
Thank you, Randy, for that movie review. Rise of 300 and Mr. Peabody and Sherman both getting 5 stars. This looks awesome. I cannot wait to see 300 Rise of an Empire. I just watched the original 300.
And it's like, how are they going to make another movie because everyone dies?
Well, because the Persians are coming in and they need to stop those Persians. And how do they get stopped? The Rise of an Empire.
Yeah.
Can't wait, though. One character I'm excited for is that woman just tearing it up with those swords, getting all those bad men.
Yeah, 300.
What?
I don't know, dude. I mean, if it's not broken, don't fix it, you know?
Or if you can keep repairing it.
It's not broken, so why repair it?
Or make it better. If you can make it better, why not make it better?
I don't think... There is no way that this 300 is going to be
better than the original. Randy gave him 5 stars.
But, I mean, if you ask Randy's opinion, I guarantee you he's going to say the original was much better than this movie. Yes, absolutely.
I'm excited for Mr. Peabody and Sherman. I grew up watching Rocky and Bullwinkle.
My favorite.
Me
I believe.
Too.
No, I was just saying, I thought I was wearing boxers.
Rocky and Bullwinkle underwear?
Boxers, yep.
But we're talking about Mr. Peabody and Sherman. Mr. Peabody on your shorts.
I don't get it.
I mean, let's go on to civic news.
Roslyn City Council met this last Tuesday, and they were talking about Rush Mountain Bike Festival that's going to be taking place this spring. There were some discrepancies about holding the event in the spring when it comes to the RUF CAC, and they thought that it was much better to actually have it in the summer just because maybe it's a little too moist on the ground, and they're afraid of treading up the Roslyn Urban Trails.
But I think we hopefully are going to get that bike race in the middle of May, and we'll have another bike race in summer, but hopefully the RUF CAC can come to an agreement and let the Mountain Bike Festival go on, because it brings so many people to our town and a lot of business to our businesses.
There you go.
Which is very important.
What happened to Cleo?
No, actually, in Roslyn, I want to get this out too. We talked about water and leasing water to our county. So please get to our special meeting on Monday. That's next week. And please voice your opinion Monday at 7 p.m. and let us know if you believe in Roslyn leasing our water rights to the county. Very important topic, and it's going to be a big one, I think.
Yep, you're going to be pulling some hairs with that one.
Ooh. Cleveland City Council, they met on the same day as the Roslyn City Council, where they talked about the Y grounds and their proposal. I've been talking about putting a road across the Y grounds, which in my defense is very beneficial, would be very nice. But Jay McGowan on the Cleveland City Council had some arguments and some poems to read about the Y ground. And Mr. Spears had some comments to say about that.
And if you missed those meetings, be sure to check them out only on NTV Channel 3 at selected times. And that concludes
Civic News. Both those meetings, Cleveland City Council and Roslyn City Council, like you said, Jeff, make sure to check them out because they are very important. And get to those city council meetings and have your voice heard.
And now moving on to
Warrior Sports. Come on, Little Warrior Sports.
Little Warrior Sports.
Yeah.
Mini Warrior Sports.
Mini Warrior Sports. We got golfing. Here's some pictures of them practicing outside in the snow. Way to rough it out there, Warriors. Getting out and swinging away the old clubs in this beautiful weather.
I wish that we had golf when we were in high school.
Yeah, me
Gosh,
too.
That would have been so fantastic.
It would have been. I know all the spring sports right now are indoors. They're in the basketball and courts, middle school and high school, but they're trying to get out there and enjoy this summertime or this sun time that we have so they can practice on the fields, because I know baseball have their first game versus Warden on Saturday.
Track met up for the first time too, and my old roommate Bryce took the long distance runners out for a long distance run too, so he's going to be helping out. So the best of luck to all the spring sport athletes. I know you guys are going to do a fantastic job. We have great coaching behind our students.
Our baseball and softball teams, and also our tennis, are looking to get to districts again and place possibly in state once again for some of them.
Let's knock on wood.
And that concludes Warrior Sports. So we just want to wrap up thanking all of our sponsors and thanking our viewers each week, bringing Jeff, Eddie, and myself into your living rooms and letting us talk about what's going on today, tomorrow, and yesterday, really.
Yep. And we'd like to shut down tonight's episode by wishing some people a very happy spring birthday, even though it's not spring yet.
Just about next week.
Almost.
On March 13th, we have Ryan Anderson, Dustin Sandage, Brandon Montgomery, and Callie Kaminga. Happy birthday.
On the 14th, we have Danielle Royal.
On March 15th, we have JC Powell, Amanda Soderstrom.
And on the 16th, we have Kieran Marquette, Bree Bergley,
and Sam Bukinich. Happy birthday, bud. On March 17th, we have Karina Wells and Teresa McFadden from Inland Networks.
And on the 18th, we have Andrew Vandevenner, Whitney Ritter, Kat Kors, and Dewar Darling.
Happy birthday to everybody. And if we missed your birthday, please don't let it happen again. Give us a call, 649-3940. Facebook us, tweet us, email us. If you see Eddie, let him know, hey, my birthday's on this day.
This has been A Couple Local Boys.
Trying to shoot some local news for you, March 13, 2014. Make sure to get out there and get some vitamin D from that sun. Is it vitamin D? Maybe vitamin E?
It's vitamin sun.
So vitamin D, Jeff. Vitamin
Why
sun.
Are you even talking to
me? I'm Nolan Weiss.
That's why it's called Sunny D Light. Sponsor us.
What was that, Eddie? Hold on, Eddie has something he wants to say.
No, I was going to say plug in the commercial.
Oh, yeah. And after this, check out Da Vinci's Demons, only on Stars. Jeff, you left.
It is a dark hour. You have failed us, Da Vinci.
I couldn't abandon Lorenzo.
So you abandon your destiny? You have allowed your sympathy to blind you to the greatest struggle.
The House of Da Vinci falls today!
Our enemies
will seize their opportunity.
The Vatican.
I speak of agents far more ancient. The blood of man is on your hands now.
I had a vision. I was in the presence of something. I must search for an ancient hidden wisdom that men have died to protect. An undiscovered land which will unlock a treasure worth a thousand cities. It contains secrets that could put an end to wars forever. It's time to save the future. This could be the gateway to extraordinary things. Where is Da Vinci?
We will apply unrelenting pressure until it surrenders.
Leonardo will come for you.
Tragically, not for you.
Some things happen to me. My life is about tempting fate.